Hi guys, so we are here a bit early. So can you just acknowledge if you can hear me? Can you just say something on the chat? If you can hear me clearly, if my voice is audible clearly. Great, great, okay. So there is no attendance form to this session, okay? It is completely your will in watching this, okay? This will definitely benefit you out. So we'll start the session very soon in a couple of minutes, and I see people are joining. So let us wait for, a couple of minutes more. Then we'll move ahead with the session. So I welcome you all to our live session on how to build a killer resume. A very, very good evening to each and everyone who has joined now and who is joining now. So as I mentioned, we have another couple of minutes before starting the session. So meanwhile, if you're here already and if you haven't subscribed our channel, please do subscribe and also hit the bell icon. So we'll also conduct more such sessions, which will definitely benefit you out. So I request everyone who's out there who has not subscribed to subscribe our channel. Hello everyone, hello everyone, good evening. So a special hi to everyone who has reached here early. So if you have reached just now, so you haven't missed anything. We are just going to start. So I see still people joining us. Let them join. So meanwhile, we'll go ahead with the session. So I hope I'm very clear. My voice is clearly audible to you all. And if you have any, doubts or if you want to ask anything, you can definitely ask at the end of the session. So in between, if you haven't understood any of the things which I'm saying, obviously you can, drop a chat then and there itself. So I welcome you all to the first live session of Skill Safari, and more such sessions are about to come, guys. So this session is all about how you're going to impress your HR interviewer by your resume. So a great thanks for everyone who have joined now. We are just about to start the session, guys. So you might be wondering who this is. So I just wanted to tell me something about myself first. So I am Naveen Chandran. Hi everyone, I'm Naveen Chandran again. So some things about myself. So I have around 7+ years of experience in the space of students grooming, talent management, talent acquisition, employability enhancement, skilling up, reskilling, and much, much more. All in associated with students upskilling and students employability enhancement. So I have traveled with a lot of students. I have traveled with n number of students all over India. So I know what and all students go through their career stuff and how they'll groom themselves, how difficult it is for them to, improvise their career and, to get a job. So we are just here to help you out, guys. So this is the first session. So I request everyone to, follow our channel, subscribe to our channel so that you will get notified what are the sessions which are upcoming, which will be really useful for your future, for your placements, for your skills, and yes, for your corporate life also. So, presently, I am one of the co-founders of this company that is Skill Safari. So I welcome you all officially to Skill Safari. So we aim and we promote our main motivation, beginning Skill Safari is to build a learn and earn community where you can learn and earn. Okay, so you upgrade your skills, you reskill yourself, and you learn and as well as you earn by choosing a career path. So, why I am conducting this session? Just a small info to you guys. So, I have spent around more than 5 years in the field of recruitment and talent acquisition, and I have come across, 10,000 and 15,000 plus candidates. And when I say candidates, obviously it is more than 10,000 plus profiles or resumes I have seen. So, that is the reason. So through my experience, through my ability to understand whatever I have seen till now, so I wanted to give a generic feedback as a session to you all guys so that you all benefit out of this session and you impress your HR interviewer. So one last thing. So definitely I and Skill Safari aim to give you adequate knowledge and idea on building a creative and amazing resume. So all these things is with the help of our amazing team, which has a very similar past experience, which all come together to provide such session. So I still see people joining in, so who have just missed till now. So this is Naveen Chandran, who is the host of this session. I welcome you all. A very, very good evening. Okay, so what are we going to do this in the session? Number one, I'm just going to tell very, very briefly what Skill Safari and what we do. Number two, why this session is currently hosted for you all. Okay, and you all know that this is not a marketing strategy. This is not a complete sales event. So this is just for your benefit. So we'll tell you why we have created such session. Next, we are going to see structure of resume. So you would have seen n number of resumes. So you would be confused, most of you, I'm not telling everyone, most of you would be confused that what is the exact structure of the resume. We are going to discuss that. And what are we going to put inside the resume? That is one thing which I'll definitely discuss with you all. And most importantly, do's and don'ts. So what and all you need to do in a resume or put in a resume or what and all things you should not or avoid putting in a resume. And finally, I'll be open for your questionnaire. So, talking about our company, so as you all know, it is Skill Safari. We redefine the online learning experience. So, Skill Safari is an e-learning platform focusing on providing skill enhancement training modules, which will upskill and upgrade one individual skill, which will enhance in a way that he is employable at the end of any course. So, this is a very niche learning pedagogy. So, which focuses on giving employability to students. So, this is very, very briefly about us. I don't want to bore you with more about the company, so I'm not doing any branding here. Yes, coming to the main point, why do we conduct such a session? Okay, or why do we, chosen a topic like how to build a resume. So building a resume is what? So we go to Google, we type resume, we get n number of formats, we copy one of the formats, we put it in Word, we edit it according to our this thing, we'll just change our name and we'll just update according to our needs. It's a 5-10 minutes work. For that, why there is a 1.5-2 hour session? Okay, as I told you before, so I was part of a big recruiting committee or a team, and as I told you, like I have come across thousands and thousands of resume. So I have observed students taking resume very lightly. Students think that it is just a piece of paper which an interviewer would not even consider seeing it. No, guys, it is not like that. So interviewer is focused on seeing your resume rather than your face in the first step when you come for an interview. First, I will see what you are on that piece of paper. Then only I will see what you are and how useful you will be to me and my company. So very clearly, I'm saying to you, don't take resumes lightly. Okay, now on a lighter part, I just wanted to give you some example of what I have, experienced or, seen in the past. So the reason why we are conducting such session for student community like yourself, okay, so you can now see mostly students have joined because we have focused completely on student community. So the session is because you should not or shouldn't ridicule yourself in front of the interviewer like these examples. So I saw one achievement in the resume. I came first in the school long distance race. Okay, at first I thought why this is there in the resume. Second, I really pondered over why, how ridiculous this particular achievement was. Yes, though it is an achievement, how this will, is a main point where this will give you a greater advantage to land in a job. Okay, this may sound a bit silly, but trust me, this is important. Okay, your school achievements are good, but whether is it useful, whether you are a sports person, all these things will come into play. So there is one more interesting thing. Email addresses. Okay, we are so casual that we have funky email addresses. Even I had funky email address when I was in college. Later I realized that it was a mistake when we put those funky email addresses in the resume. Okay. Because resume is a professional profile. Though it is one page, it is a professional profile. So email addresses like lazysoda@gmail.com. So definitely we as a recruiter or an interviewer will find this funny, but we'll not find it impressive or we'll not have a good impression on the candidate. So when you create email addresses, or if you have email addresses of such kind, make sure that you create a professional email address. And I came across someone's achievement as being sober. Okay, so you can understand how and all I am seeing and what are the kinds of, you know, beings I have come across. So when you see your achievement as being sober, you can imagine, okay, the kind of ridicule this guy has, you know, brought into the resume. So let's say there was another interesting scenario where a guy was, you know, I asked a guy why he left his older job. So he had written in the resume very clearly saying it was hard work. Okay, it was for hard work. So, you know, giving a different phrase is okay. But altogether, making a blunder, spelling mistake is unacceptable. That too in a printed resume, isn't it? So when you see hobbies, this is not martial art, guys. If you have read it wrong, okay, correct yourself. It is not martial arts. It is marital arts. So you know what is marital arts, right? So marital is what? What do you mean by marital status? Like whether you are married or not. Okay, so this is something related to marriage. So, yes, it is an obvious mistake. I am not saying that this is a, you know, intentionally put pun on a resume. So, I also know that is a mistake. But, yes, that is a document at the end of the day. So, that shows your, you know, commitment in doing some work. Okay, and that work here is resume. So, will I have a good impression on you when you make such blunders on the resume? Definitely no. I see some hobbies to be space travel and all. Okay, I don't know how he had written space travel. But yes, I did ask him how your hobby is space travel. He coolly replied me saying that I travel in space in, you know, while playing video games. Okay. So, I replied him very coolly that probably you should go and look for a job in the same video game. So, we have these kind of people, okay. We cannot avoid or we cannot, you know. But why I'm telling you all these things is that you might be someone who might make these mistakes. Okay, I'm not telling these mistakes are intentional. Okay, but yes, but these mistakes can happen to anyone. Even to me, it would have happened. At that time, there was no one to guide me by keeping such a session. So, that's why we have made it very handy to you all. Okay. So, someone wrote like this, I would like to assure you that I am a hardly working person. Okay. Mentioning something like hardworking person in a resume itself is a ridicule. Okay. Let's forget that. Okay, let's say that he wanted to make a point. That's why he documented and printed it. I would like to assure you that I am a hardly working person. But here, Grammarly slightly went against his words. So, when I say I hardly work, that means that I don't work hard. It means that I hardly work. That means that I work sometimes. Okay, that is what it means, right? Hardly. So, these kind of things definitely will bring embarrassment to yourself when you're in front of a resume. I mean, sorry, interviewer. So, that there was one yet another interesting hobbies which I came across. Enjoy cooking Chinese and Italians. Okay. So, I understood the context. Okay, there was this girl who came up this resume, enjoy cooking Chinese and Italians. I obviously understood the context. But, I asked her, do you really meant these sentences? She told, yes, I really love cooking Chinese. Okay, do you love cooking Chinese people or do you love cooking Chinese food? Sir, what? No, Chinese food. So, whereas in this statement, there is no area or no representation of, you know, she interested in cooking Chinese food. Okay, when you say enjoy cooking Chinese and Italians, it means that your hobby is to cook Chinese and Italian people, isn't it? So yes, very minute mistake, I agree. Okay, anyone can do this mistake, but I am telling you, I'm giving you this example because you shouldn't be the one who should be making these kind of mistakes. Okay. Another crazy spelling mistake which I came across was I speak English and spinach. So it's like you speak English and invented a new language called spinach or Palak, and you try speaking that. Okay. So what I'm trying to say here is you have to be really, really careful. Okay. When you create a resume, is, a document at the end of the day. The document is going to be seen by your recruiter, okay, who's going to recruit you, who's going to give you a job. Okay, so you need to impress him by showing how committed you are in a single piece of paper also. Yes, this email ID is really crazy. hotsexylove@gmail.com. So guys, please don't ever bring such email IDs onto the paper in a resume. Okay. So this is the last example I wanted to show you. Left last four jobs only because the managers were completely unreasonable. So he lost four jobs. Okay. And when we asked the reason, he mentioned because of the managers and they were unreasonable. Okay. This he could have said in an interview and he could have given an explanation, but he mentioned this in his resume. So now, do you get that we come across so many? So this is just, hardly I took some 10 examples just to show you how a resume can be ridiculed. Okay, so that is the main thing which I wanted to show you. But can you see the amount of, carelessness which is being poured here when I read across these examples? Isn't it? It's really bad from recruiter's point of view. No, you need to think from their point of view also. So before starting the session, I would like to tell you that please take this session seriously. Okay. So if you have not gone, if you missed anything in between, or if you're gone in between somewhere, so do come back and watch this complete session. Okay. And I'll also provide you with some deliverables which you can take it, and I am going to give you some templates. So I'll just post the drive link in the comment session or the description session. So we are about to start the session, guys. So I welcome you all to how to build a killer resume and impress your HR at first look. Okay, so before getting into the session, I want to know whether you guys know what is a resume, okay, and how it is actually pronounced. A lot of people don't know how it is pronounced. Okay, so how it is pronounced? It is not pronounced as resume, it is not pronounced as resume, it is pronounced resume. How it is pronounced? It is pronounced resume. Why like that? It is because it is not an English word. Okay. So yes, we are going to see the differences and similarities between a curriculum vitae, a biodata, and a resume. So what sets each other apart? Number one, curriculum vitae. It is a Latin word which means course of life. So which means course of life. So what and when curriculum vitae or CV in short is used. So curriculum vitae is a broader aspect where you mention your skills in depth, especially when you apply for a bigger post or a specific research post or a specific scholar post. So at that point, you will give a curriculum vitae where you will have a huge experience. Okay, so that curriculum vitae's paper size itself will be like more than 3 pages. So that is curriculum vitae for you. And biodata, as you all know, biodata is a very old school. Probably your fathers and grandfathers would have used biodata. Biodata is nothing but biographical data. And as I told you, it is very old school, which will have everything like your name, starting from your name, from your ethnicity, your height, weight, everything it will have. So it is basically what and all you have done from the birth. That kind of thing is biodata, which is not used extensively now. So you just have to, you know, skip biodata. Don't prepare biodata, especially if you're not joining some fitness or, you know, defense. At that point, you would require a biodata, yes. So coming to resume. So resume is a French word, which means summary. So resume is a French word, which means summary. So resume is aptly, you know, definitely made for freshers or entry level positions. Okay. So while resumes are widely recommended, if you have relatively limited career experience, okay, or no career experience. So that's why I'm telling this freshers or entry level. And whereas CVs or curriculum vitae are preferable if you plan to apply for jobs in, you know, academia or possess a wide array of relevant skills and experiences, that would not be typically added in a resume, or it will not come in a resume. You need to explain your niche skill sets broadly, which can fit into a curriculum vitae. Okay. So the very first step in determining whether to use a curriculum vitae or resume is to determine your skills and your skill sets, whether it matches or satisfies the job roles. So it is best to avoid using a curriculum vitae when a resume itself will do what is required. So if you are a fresher or if you are an entry level graduate where you are about to go for a job, in that case it is going to be resume. So that's the reason why our complete session is focused on resume and not curriculum vitae. So if anyone wants a special session on curriculum vitae, please leave in the comments. We'll plan some other day for curriculum vitae. And these three are the okay. And one latest thing have come. So nowadays it is very popular, which is called online portfolio. It is very modern and it is completely online, where you will build a resume itself online using, you know, HTML and CSS. So it basically represents to showcase your skills, your creativity skills and your work. So if you are a developer, okay, you can definitely have an online portfolio over resume, because developers can have multiple projects, you know, stored in repository of GitHub, where they can run the project then and there and show the interviewer. So online portfolio is for developers especially, and have work or have projects online, which whereas they can showcase the projects. Okay, we will definitely have a separate session on how to make an online portfolio using HTML, CSS and Bootstrap. So which we'll shortly have a live session. So we'll definitely intimate you. So do come and visit if you are a developer, if you are a, a front-end developer or a full-stack developer. It will be really useful for you. So now for this session, we are going to stick with resume. Okay. So most employers are familiar with resumes and expect all entry-level candidates to submit a single-page resume. Okay. Two-page maximum, but I myself would say you to submit a single-page resume. That is enough. So that is enough for you all to showcase what you have done in your career of 23 years, 22 years. So the major exception to this unspoken rule is for positions within academia. Okay. For example, even an entry-level candidate for an academic position can be expected to submit a CV. So when you go for academia and research, that is different. At that point, your resume will not work. Okay. Only curriculum vitae will work. But now we are going to be open for, you know, all IT and ITES jobs. Okay. So which will be more into corporate world. So corporate world will definitely require your resume. So finally, to summarize, a resume would be ideally suited when experienced people apply for a specific position where certain specific skills are more important than your educations or experience, work experience. So, and on other hand, a curriculum vitae or CV should be preferred option for fresh graduates or people looking for career change in academia. So finally, biodata is most used in Asian countries, where people apply for government jobs, where people apply for defense, for and also for research grants, where one has to submit a descriptive essays. Okay, now we are going to see the structure of a resume. So, I'll tell you how the structure of a resume should be. So, it should be a brief profile. So, you should highlight the skills and experiences you bring to the position. So, that is the first and foremost. Second, your education details, brief description in reverse chronological order. That is, your latest degree putting first. So, if you have done a PG degree, PG degree, UG degree, 12th and 10th. And professional experience. So, professional experience, if you have anything to put up, put inside the resume, great. So, if you feel that you do not have any professional experience in terms of job, it's okay. If you have done any internships, please write that. Or if you have done projects for your college, and your college projects will also come under professional experience, because you are applying certain skills to complete a project and you are going to complete a final thesis as well as the output, isn't it? So that is also considered professional experience in terms when you are a fresh graduate or entry level graduate. So again, next experiences comes where you display your jobs, internships, industry experiences, whatever workshops you have gone, all these things comes under experience. Then professional affiliations, if any, so certifications or if you have done any courses, so all these things will come under professional affiliations. And hobbies and interest, this is completely optional, right? Only if you want to write, if you have a interesting hobby which you want to showcase your personality, which would come into picture when you feel that the HR or the interviewer would be impressed by your hobby, only then you mention hobbies or interest. So this is the broader structure of the resume, guys. So there should be a profile, so which will highlight your skills, okay, which will highlight your objective. Second, your education qualification. Then professional experience, which will tell what you have done, what kind of skills you possess. Are you fit? Are you a right fit for this job? Then experiences, any real-time experiences, if you have, like internships, industry experience, workshops, and professional affiliations like certifications. So this is the structure of the resume. Okay, now let's completely focus. I believe a lot of people who have joined today are, entry-level graduates or freshers. So lot of people have this, a bigger, a larger question, how I should write a resume when I do not have any experience at all. Okay, I do not have any experience because I am a fresher, a complete fresher. When I go and see in the internet, I get all experience. So how do I put my experience in the resume because I don't have any experience? No, guys. When we say experience, yes, even a fresher would have experience. So experience in terms of projects, experience in terms of internship, experience in terms of industry visits, experience in terms of college clubs, okay, where you would have given a lot of contribution in terms of providing good content, or if you have designed any kind of website for your college. All these things are experience which you can definitely put on the resume if you feel like it will add value. First, entry level resume should have objective. Okay, so mention what are you looking for and what skills you possess to offer for the job. That is what you need to write in the objective. Not like I am a hardworking, determined person wanting to work in a reputed organization to bring value for myself and the organization. All these gyans are not required. Okay, stick to the point. Okay, stick to the point. Mention what are you looking for and what skills you possess to get the job offer. Very simple. Work experience. Okay, mention your previous job roles or internships and skills. Whatever you have contributed in your college life, or if you have worked, definitely your work experience will come into picture. So you need to do it in a reverse chronological order. Next is your education. So mention your graduation and schooling again in reverse chronological order. Yes, definitely you need to highlight what are the skills you possess technically. Okay, and how these skills would land you a job which you are applying for. And interest, mention some of your productive, I repeat myself, productive hobbies or interest. Yes, and very, very important, contact details, which will be your header of the resume, which will be your header of resume. So contact details, what and all I should give, we'll discuss. Okay, now let's see how you're going to put all these things, all entry level resume things inside a resume. Number one, as I told you, your contact details should be your header. Okay, I'm just giving you information how you want to put, how well it should look, all these things you can do it. Okay, don't show completely very decorative resumes or decorative content. Just stick to the point. Okay, put whatever is required. So whatever is required in the header, your name is required, your address is absolutely required, your phone number, if you're giving a landline phone number, it is again optional, but you need to give a cell phone number or a mobile number, and you need to give your correct email ID. So email ID, as discussed before, it should not be some funky email ID. Okay, so give a professional email ID. If you don't have one, create one professional email ID, and you can go ahead with your header part. So these four things will fill your header part. So next is going to be your objective. So objective or career objective. So we'll split this career objective into four parts, guys. So first is job description. Next is the actual objective. Next is experience. And next is skill keywords. So what are the skill keywords you possess? So first one is job description. So the current job or applied job. So if someone is coming for recruitment, if some company is coming for recruitment, you will obviously know which position they are hiring for. So based on that, so tell them that you are applied for this job. And next is the objective, what you are actually having to look for. Okay. And next is the experience, how much practical experience you have for that job, or how much projects you have done, what an internship you have done. So for example, let's say that a company XYZ is coming to your college and they are offering you a position of web development. So when I say experience here, though you don't have a actual real-time experience with the company, you would have created projects with a few technologies which you would have learned, like HTML, CSS, JavaScript, all these things. So all these things are keywords which you need to mention in the objective. So I'll just give you a small example where you can see how objectives are. So there is this example. There is a guy called Alex. So just look at the objective. There is four parts: job title, objective, skill keywords, and experience. Okay. So here, when I say experience, he has mentioned in terms of numbers, like years of experience. So if you don't have a number, you can include it with your projects or internships, those kind of things. Okay. So job title is elementary teacher or aspiring front end developer. Okay, looking for a position, entry level position. Okay, in a growing company where I can apply my what experience? Experience in web development and backend technology. Okay, with the skills I have learned like HTML, CSS, JavaScript, jQuery. Okay, Django, whatever. So you understood, right? What I'm trying to say. So career objective should be very specific, guys. So make sure your objective does not, wander here and there. Okay. And if you look in the internet for objectives, definitely you're going to confuse yourself. So that is to pakka. So make sure whatever objective you are writing, you write by your own based on your skill set. Hope you got me, guys. Next is experiences. So I would like to tell this particular part is for people who have got a job experience or work experience. Also people who have not got any experience who are freshers. Okay. So even experiences or projects should be in reverse chronological order, where latest should come first and followed by your next project. So next, first is you need to write latest job, so which you have done latest, that is 2017 to 2019. So if you have done a project in 2019, you need to write that first, then next project. So this is how you will be writing in reverse chronological order. So what you need to write, that is our next important question, isn't it? Okay, so this is a small format which I can give you. So company name or project name you can write, and duration or when it got over that year you can write, or you can ignore that. Okay, job or position title or project title. So people who are freshers, you have to write project title there. Okay, then list your responsibilities for the job or project. Okay, what are the adaptations you did? Okay, try to keep it short, get straight to the point. Don't omit important information like what are the skills you applied for doing that project, or what are the skills you learned in your previous job. So this is how it works, guys. So you write your project in a reverse chronological order. Your project will be treated as experience when you are a fresher. And people with experience, that will be your experience. So not the projects, the companies you worked in. So it also should be in reverse chronological order. And the things which are listed here are the things which should come inside the project body or work experience body. Hope that is clear. And next is education qualification. You can, as I told you, so just write what is the degree you did, okay, in which branch or which technology you did that graduation, which university, and how much CGPA. These four informations are enough. Similarly, this also should be in reverse chronological order, where your latest will come first and the things which you did earlier will come below. So first, your post graduation will come, next your undergraduation will come, next 12th, next 10th. So you can just make a small table in your resume. Okay, next, what else I can write in a resume? Okay. You need to write skills, basically, technical skills. Okay. So, I've just added a simple example as I gave you an example of, you know, job position of web development has come to your college and they're looking for certain skills. So, in that case, these will be the skills which will be required. So, web development, database, content writing, Photoshop. So, technical skills, what and all you possess is there, which is web development. And if you have Photoshop and Adobe XD, that means you know to design UI UX, okay, user interface and user experience. And you also know backend development, that is React.js, and you also know Node.js, and you also know some databases like MySQL, MongoDB and all. So this is how you project your technical skills. So here, this is a graphical representation. I just wanted it to be, you know, some kind of funky. So if you want to represent like this in on your resume, it is no harm, but make sure that your resume does not become clumsy. Okay. And I prefer resume to be put in just one page. So next is if you want to write some other skills like computer skills. So let's say if you know DBMS, so you can put something like this. So how competent you are in that skill. So DBMS, like basic competent, proficient, expert. So these four categories you can keep. So DBMS, competent, SEO, if you're good at. So I'm good at SEO, so I put it proficient. So communication tools, I know communication tools, I have done well. So MS Office, so I don't know all MS Office stuff, so but yes, I am almost proficient in that. So these are different ways where you can represent your skills, guys, because your resume should speak about your skills mainly, because you don't have, you know, a professional experience, so your skills will definitely come into picture. So if you want to get attention of your HR, then definitely you need to put skills in the picture. Yes. So this is one way where how you can represent skills. This is one way how you can represent this other skills. Next, coming to hobbies, again and again I'm telling you this, when you write hobbies, make sure that you write productive hobbies. So like gardening, and it is very good if you can give you know, a reason for it, like gardening helps me reduce stress. Okay. Painting brings out a creative child within me. Camping. I love being close to nature to keep myself more humane. And reading news. I like to keep myself updated with current affairs. So all these things are productive hobbies. So here I am not saying that I like watching TV. Watching TV is an unproductive hobby. So don't write it. I like to surf on internet. It is an unproductive hobby. So you should be specific if you're surfing on internet. So it's like you surf on internet to read some blogs. You surf on internet to read some technology news. So these things. So when you just generally put that I like surfing, that means that it's an unproductive hobby. I like to listen to songs. Listen songs for relaxation is different, but listening to songs as a hobby is unproductive. Again, listening to songs or music for leisure, for relaxation is different. Listening to songs or music as a hobby is unproductive. So you need to differentiate productive and unproductive hobbies. And yes, especially clearly represent or clearly put your hobbies very clearly. And don't end up putting like I like cooking Chinese and Italians. Okay. So this is what I want to tell about hobbies. So if you feel that I don't have any productive hobby, please don't write hobbies at all. And you can obviously put language skills, like what are the languages you know, how proficient are you in the language. This is one way of representing language skills. So I'm just showing you different designs so you can use in a resume if you are good at Photoshop, if you're good at designing, But make sure that it does not become more clumsy and it does not become more unprofessional. So if you feel that you can design it professionally, only design a creative resume then. Especially this will work for people who have a huge interest in designing Photoshop and Illustrator and all. So for rest of you, I would advise you that you just go for normal written documented resume, just a one page simple resume where you mention your skills, which will be sufficient enough to get yourself land a job. Okay. Yes, common do's and don'ts in the world of resume writing. That is what we are going to discuss now. So before discussing that, okay, I would like to discuss some other things. Okay. Number one, so whatever we have discussed right now, so we are going to give a quick recap. So I want to discuss or emphasize more on some important elements which is to be included on your entry-level resume. So contact information. Again, I'm stressing contact information is must. Very, very careful while adding it. So make sure to include your email, phone number, and other contact information without fail. Okay, so that it is easy for hiring managers to get in touch. And one small tip is that make sure your email address is professional. So one small example would be firstname.lastname@gmail.com or whatever. Okay, so next, when you write about the experience, again, I'm saying you may not have a full-time job experience with you, but have you worked part-time? That is one question you need to ask. All sort of experience are suitable to list out, including summer jobs, summer internships, volunteerings, positionings, and your club activities. Your college club activities. So you can also include extracurricular activities. So next is education. As well as mentioning degrees, you can also break out relevant courseworks also, as I told earlier. So courseworks and certifications. So write your education experience in reverse chronological order. Okay. Next is skills. As I told you, split your skills on what you have, like technical skills, computer skills, life skills, all these things you can add in a resume. So include anything that might be helpful in the workplace. Remember that thing and add the skills. So even from the language you speak and proficiency level with the languages, proficiency level with computer programs, proficiency level with computer basics like your Microsoft Office, all these things. So, and one final thing which I wanted to tell you, objective section. So please be very careful while writing objective section. So remember the four things which I mentioned. If you had forgotten, don't worry. You come back to this video, just go to those four sessions and try building objectives in those four sessions. And so this section is really important. Okay, but if you feel that you do not have any objective at all or you are not able to make one objective, it's okay. Just ignore objective or omit objective part and go on to the next. But it is really great place to emphasize how your particular skill match the position which you have applied for. So you might mention your organization skills for an admin position or your hobby of building websites for your friends. So, or building a website for your college, all these things are, important aspects where you can mention an objective as is your skill. So, before writing resume, I wanted to tell you some more things. So, don't rush in writing resumes. Take out a pen and paper.
Okay, before you begin, list all your experiences. So just think, because you might miss when you start thinking and typing. So first jot down all you know before writing a resume. So take a blank paper or a notebook. Okay, think, sit down, think, and list out all your experience first. Includes internships, volunteer work, student activities, important class projects, group projects, mini projects. Then think about which skill you learned in any online session. As a result, this would have, you know, converted as an experience. So as you assemble your resume, you may be surprised to find out how much you can include. That's the reason, before building a resume, sit down in a quiet place, think what you have done in your life, okay, what you have done in this 20 years, and how you can show yourself worth enough to get yourself a job. Okay, next thing, talk about goals you've accomplished. So after writing down all the experiences, talk about goals you accomplished. So remember to always highlight some good achievements which you have done in or achieved in the college, probably getting some sponsorship amount from a company, or getting on the company for any event. So, or if you were a director, if you have become a director of any clubs, so president of any clubs, so all these things are, you know, little accomplishments which can speak value as a fresher, especially. Okay. And final thing I wanted to tell you is proofread. Okay. So it is no harm in you reading your own life resume, okay, for like 10 times, okay, for like 10 times, no harm, read it, no issues. But
I want you to tell you that you need to be very, very careful while vetting out your resume, because we are not document writer that or content writer where we would have, you know, written a great resume, because we are human, we are normal human, we are entry level freshers, we don't have much experience in writing stuff. So I will sit down, read every line in order to make sure there is no spelling mistakes, there is no grammatical mistakes. All these things are really important. So proofreading is one of the important things. So now I would like to come into the point of do's and don'ts. Okay, 1 second. People are saying that my voice is breaking. Can you give me an acknowledgement if you can hear my voice properly? Am I clear, audible, clear enough? Am I clear enough? Shall we proceed to the session? Great. Thank you for the acknowledgement. So, yes, coming to do's and don'ts. First, related to showing off your skills or experiences. Okay. So first thing what you need to do is do highlight your most relevant experiences. Okay, so when I say highlight your most relevant experiences, that means rule number one of resume writing is that you should be turning in a different version for each role you've applied to. So don't be in an attitude that your single resume can cross 10 companies. If that is the attitude, then it will not cross 10 companies, it will cross 50 companies also. But your objective is not that. Your objective is to get landed in a job. Okay, so make sure you update your resume according to companies and according to positions. So that is one thing. So always tailor and target the position. So
Your resume should demonstrate you to have a specific set of skills, experience, and accomplishments which are necessary to do the job. So that's the reason why you need to update your resume for every job role, for every job position. So make it easy for the hiring manager to see why you fit in right there. Next. Please don't freak out if you have no relevant experience. Okay, it's okay. As I told you, it's okay to be a fresher. Everyone was a fresher once. So whether you are fresh out of college or if you want to switch into a brand new industry, it's not an issue. You can help, pile up, and you can cement your lack of work experience or relevant experience by your transferable skills or the skills you have learned when you were in college or when you studied or with your project, with your internship or any courseworks. All these things you can mention it in the resume. So please do mention whatever you have done, okay, in curriculum part. So if you have done a course, mention it. If you have done a training, mention it. Okay, if you have done a project, mention it. Okay, so if you have done an internship, yes, do mention it. Next, don't steal the job description. So for example, let's say that there is a company coming to your college or you are applying for a job. Okay, so let's say if a company says it's looking for candidates who learn rapidly and have a diverse knowledge of programming languages. So this might be the job description mentioned. Okay, you will get a job description if a company comes, no? So you should not change in the resume, or your resume shouldn't read like I can learn rapidly and have a diverse knowledge of programming languages. So make sure that you make or you put it in a different way. You find a different way of saying the same thing. Maybe devote a resume bullet towards softwares which you have learned in 2 weeks, or if you have any different programming languages which you are familiar with, you can mention it. So something like that. So don't put the same word, but mention it with your skills. Yes, do use data. So number speaks a lot more than words. So let's say if you have come first in some competition, okay, let's say hackathon. So let's say you are in top 10 of hackathon, mention it. You are in top 10 of hackathon. Let's say you were top 5 in a competitive programming. So you can mention all those things. So you need to use data, okay, or numbers very precisely. So let's say you have driven sales by 300%. Great, mention it. Definitely mention it. Don't include some obvious skills. Okay, that is one thing, one common mistake which everyone will do. For example, nowadays everyone knows Microsoft Word, okay, and everyone knows how to use internet. So don't use experience in Microsoft Word or proficiency in Microsoft Word, proficiency in browsing or using internet as your skills. Okay, these represents very naive characteristics. Okay, so I'm not saying that you shouldn't mention, but it will look very, very naive. Okay, especially with the faster technology rate at which we are currently moving, you should definitely avoid even putting MS Office. So MS Office is a huge thing. Okay, so putting Microsoft Word is a bad idea. Okay, so don't include some obvious skills. Okay, do consider volunteer or other non-work experience also. So it is, yes, obviously a non-traditional thing. So if volunteer work has taken up a significant chunk of your time, or it has not given you something, then think about putting it on your resume. Okay, because you have invested a lot of time in doing volunteerings,
and other non-work experience, you can put it. So these also have specific skills where you come to people, you talk to people, you do work for people, okay, you understand their problems, you try to give them some findings for it. So all these things are important. Okay, one thing which I don't want you to do is don't include work with controversial organizations. So, for example, maybe that volunteer work which you have done for a politician or a political party, please don't include that. Or probably, you know, doing a volunteer stuff at LGBT resource organization. So all these things are, you know, controversial organizations. So don't mention all these things because it is not that something which you shouldn't do. Okay, everyone encourages you to do, that is a different story. But as it is a controversial story out there in the world, so it is better not mentioning it on the resume. Not every recruiter will take it straightforward. Okay, so that is one thing which I wanted to tell you. So you can include personal accomplishments, so nothing harm in that. So if you've done something cool, very cool in your personal life, that either shows off your you know, soft skills or engages your technical skills in a new way, you should definitely include it. So maybe let's say you are a marathon runner, or you go for adventures then and there, and you have a strong work ethic, or you do some challenging stuffs, some you know, tournaments, all these things, all these accomplishments you can definitely include. So you can include under the category called extracurricular activities. So if you have any accomplishments to show off in your curriculum, you can add co-curricular activities. So under co-curricular activities, all your curriculum based competitions and achievements will come. Under extracurricular activities, all extra things apart from curriculum will come, like your sports, like your marathon sports and dance, whatever, photography, all these things will come. Don't include random, unrelated or off-putting hobbies. I have already mentioned it, but I wanted to, you know, mention it again. Okay, so please don't put unproductive hobbies. Yes, do consider a summary statement. So if you have space, definitely do consider a summary statement that what kind of a person you are and how your skills can help the company. So just to just as a conclusion statement. Okay. And yes, very, very important, do tell the truth. Okay, do not go and throw off yourself somewhere. Okay, definitely do tell the truth for obvious reasons. Anything that is not 100% true does not belong on your resume. Okay, repeating again, anything that is not 100% true of yourself, then it does not belong on your resume. So make sure you tell the truth, you earn the job. Okay. Yes. Next is, when you write, make sure that you choose words very carefully. Okay, choosing words is very, very important. So for example, don't use cliche or jargon. So I hope what you mean when I say cliche or jargon, what I mean. So because hiring managers are really, really tired of seeing description like, you know, hard worker, team player, detail oriented, all these things on the resume. So you should be also careful about any industry or role specific jargons you use. So for example, in many companies, if you want to your resume to land, so don't use that I was, you know, productivity driven intern at so and so company. So this is a jargon, so no one will understand what you have mentioned. So be very specific. Okay,
So be very specific, put everything in a terms where a lay person or a layman can understand. That means use simple English. Understood? And don't use negative phrases. So when I say negative phrases, which can even throw off some weaknesses of the table, okay? So you should also be careful of using words with negative connotation. So even if you're using them in a positive light, for example, let's say I have met aggressive sales goals, or I have met goals aggressively. So this aggression is a negative term. So don't use words like aggression, with problem. Okay, don't use problem. Okay, ambitious. So like I have delivered something on ambitious effort. So ambitious, that means that you are also trying to show yourself that you are something proud of. So that pride also should be suppressed. So make sure that you don't use words which focuses negativity, which shows pride, or which shows overconfidence. So all these three things don't use. Hope you're getting me. Yes, you can use, instead of these things, you can use some powerful verbs. So I can tell a few powerful words like, led a team, handled a team, managed a company, chartered, administered, maximized, consolidated. So all these words are really powerful, which makes you look both confident and competitive. So there are a lot of things you can, I actually have a huge list of words also. You can just mention the comment with your email ID, I can send you also. You can use it in your, not in only in your resume, but also for your future reference documents. So if you are putting references, just mention it. Don't ever include something like references upon request. Okay. It takes you, in the room, you could otherwise use, experience and skills. It looks very presumptuous. So don't use that, okay, only when you request, I can arrange for a, reference. So either don't include reference or put reference. Give references of your, some good contact. So yes, this is pretty basic, which I am keeping on telling you again and again. You need to have this. That is the reason I'm telling you again and again, you should not miss. So your name, your email ID, phone number, address, and yes, I forgot to mention your LinkedIn URL. So hope everyone is there on LinkedIn. So definitely include your LinkedIn URL. Yes, don't include anything that can be, discriminating against. So it's actually illegal to discriminate against a job because of his age, marital status, gender, religion, race, color, national origin. So it doesn't mean it doesn't happen subconsciously. Don't give recruiter the chance and just leave these details off. So don't include these things. Not only this, don't include your parents' name. Don't include what your father does. Don't include what your mother does. Don't include your nationality. Okay. Don't include your age. Don't include your gender. Okay. Don't include your marital status. So none of these things are required in a resume. So a lot of people tell that you need to put something like personal details, give your father's name, mother's name, nationality, age, gender. No, none of these. Just ignore it. Don't give all these information. It's just not required. It is not required for the recruiter to know all these details. He is going to hire you for your skills. So don't include it. Yes, finally, make it look amazing. So
that is how a killer resume is, you know, finally made. So do keep it to one page. So because I know how tiring resume reading is, because I have done a lot of interviews. So recruiters read a lot of resumes. Say they don't want to, you know, spend a lot of time looking your 2-page, 3-page resume. Cut it down to most relevant information. Keep it short and succinct. So I recommend 1-page resume for every 10 years of work experience as a good rule of thumb. Don't squish it all in. So, okay, Naveen has told that I should only keep 1 page, but I have a lot of things to put. So what I'll do, make the font size small and I'll put everything inside. No, don't squish it inside. Okay. So like you put a 8-size font with no white space on your page. So I will not feel like reading it. Okay. Make sure that you put relevant information, cut down information which is not relevant. You might feel that is relevant, but yes, that is the reason you should sit and think. Okay, put information or cut down information to an amount of information which you can comfortably fit in a single page. Okay, in a very readable font with enough white space. So white space is important because it is easy on the eyes. So don't squish it. Don't make your resume cluttered. Do consider a creative or digital resume, as I mentioned earlier. If you don't know to create a digital resume, okay, we are going to create a session, a live session for this also very soon. And if you want it, you can put it in the comment section that you want it. And also you can all put all those things what and all you want in a comment session. Okay, so lastly, don't spend all your time on the design. Design is not important. That's the reason I have not focused much thing on design. So design, I'm just leaving it here. Okay, where you can have n number of designs on the internet. Okay, you can have all your designs like infographics, data visualization, all these things, yes, look good. But if you think this might be the right route for you, there are great options. Okay, even digital option is digital resume is one of the good option. So that is also one good thing. And finally, do start from a template. Once you set, write down all your experiences and skills. Okay, you jot down all necessary points on a blank paper. Okay, do start from a template. So I have a few templates to show you. Okay, so yes, so we'll see that. So talking about fonts, so use professional font. So one font I would suggest for you is Lato, LATO, which is very, very professional. And yes, Calibri Body is also a good font. Okay, don't go for old school fonts like Times New Roman. That is pretty old, guys. So, and don't go overboard with text effects like bold, italic, underline, all these things. So don't show your resume thick and dark, thick and light, all these things. So just have a consistency. Just heading, make it bold. And rest of the things, make it normal. If you want to highlight anything, just as underline would be done. So make sure. So alignment is really, really important. So all these things is towards the end. That's why I'm telling it in the end. So do align your dates, location, all these things to your right. So that is a professional way of representing. So so one thing which I wanted to tell you is, once you are done with your content checking, foolproof, so make sure that your design looks good, readable and presentable, then you can go for cross checks. So don't use more than 2 lines per bullet. So that is also there. So if you're using bullet points, make sure that you finish that bullet in the same line itself. don't go for second line. Okay, and one final warning: never ever send your resume in Word document. Save it as a PDF, then send it. So this is a professional thing. Okay, you can ask me in written that if I send it as PDF, if they can download it and convert it into Word and change things. Yes, possible, but at least you will have a proof that you have sent it as a PDF. Okay, and you're not fool enough to send it as a Word. Okay, so if something happens, so this will be my response to you if you ask me that question. So send it as a PDF. So that is a professional way of doing it. Finally, get things done, guys. So that is the final thing. Final, once you finish with your designs, okay. So do swap your resumes with colleges and staffs. So look how they describe their, things in the resume. Chances are you will get some inspiration from your own descriptions, or your friends or staffs would be inspired, and they also can give you some good input. So having some fresh eyes look at your resume is always beneficially because they can come up with good relevant suggestions. So don't forget to spell check. That's why I'm telling you again. So do create a master resume, from that master resume you need to create all other following resumes, that is based on the job which you are applying for. Finally, again I'm telling, proofread. This is the final step which you will be doing it. Yes, guys, so I read some of your comments. Some of you are asking whether should I add personal information in the resume. Personal information should be your name, your email ID, your phone number and your address. That's it. No date of birth, no father's name, mother's name, father's profession, mother's profession, nationality, married or unmarried, nothing. And one final mistake people do is, finally they give consent, okay, that whatever I have mentioned in the resume is true to my knowledge, so I give the consent and sign. No, guys, okay, those days are gone. Okay, don't include that also. Don't include the final consent. Okay, so I'm going to show you some templates. So this is one template. Okay, so I'm going to show you not so fancy templates, but yes, a single one page template where you can fit in some things which are, you know, good and readable. So as I told you, this is the header part, and I hope everyone can see. So you include your address, email ID and phone number. You give your summary. Summary, you can replace it with objective, or summary, you can include summary as a overall summary. Before work experience, you can include objective. So expertise in terms of skill sets. Okay, so this is one format. This is another format where there is a header. There is profile. In terms of profile, you need to put it as objective. Experience, education. So experience, you can put your projects and skills. Skill set, you can add another column called skill set. So this is another resume where about me, you can include it as a profile, or you can include objective. Okay, skills, what and all you do. Okay, right, technical skills. So work experience or projects, whatever you've done, education. This is one more format. This is one format. So wherever profile is there, you just replace it with objective, career objective.
So this is another format. So I have a few formats like this. So I can definitely give it to you if you want. Just put it in comments. Probably I'll add it in a drive and send you the link. Okay, so I hope you have understood how to build a good resume till now. So I can give you all those templates, guys, don't worry, and I'll put it in a drive and I'll just send you the link. So I hope you guys have got much valuable information where you can build a resume from the scratch. Okay, please make sure you follow all the things which I have told you. Okay, so if you have not got anything very clear, the video will still be here hosted. Come back, watch it again and again so that you get hold of resume building. Okay, and you come to a position where you give tips to your juniors and your friends. Okay, thank you guys, thank you. This is the end of the session. So we are open for questionnaire now. So any questions? You can find my email ID if you have any doubts, if you want to ask anything to me. My email ID is just right there. It's naveen@skillsafari.in, and that is my official number. You can give me a ping whenever you want. And that is our website. You can please do follow our social pages, Facebook, Instagram, LinkedIn, Twitter, and obviously YouTube. Okay, so hope the session was informative. So I'm still waiting for questions. So people are asking me to send the link. Yes, definitely I'll send it. I'll update in the caption. So anything else? So here I have used this. If you are wondering how did I made this presentation, so I made this presentation with a tool called SlidesGo. Okay, it is a free tool. Okay, so you can use this theme to build your own resume in PowerPoint presentation also. There are a lot of, they would give you a lot of templates. Okay, someone is asking, is building a good LinkedIn profile is important as I am a fresher? See, Yuvraj, if you had asked this question like 5 years back, I would have said no. But right now, we are in an era where technology is booming like anything. And students are so advanced, students are so exposed to the technology things. So students learn, full stack development, students learn artificial intelligence with machine learning, Python. Their knowledge and they're expanding their knowledge. So yes, so how are you going to showcase all these things, whatever you are doing, whatever you are earning and learning, how are you going to showcase these things? You will be showcasing it in LinkedIn only. So LinkedIn is very, very important. If any of you have not opened LinkedIn, so definitely open LinkedIn. So if you want me to take another session on creating a good LinkedIn profile, I would be happy to take it. So just mention in the comments. Okay, so do mention the comments, not in the chat. So so that's the reason. So building a good LinkedIn profile is important. Yes. Sonia, I would love to do it if I have time. You have my email ID. You can email your resume to my email ID. Whenever I have time, I'll definitely review your resume and give you feedback. Sabarna, do you need to prove everything, whatever we write in the resume in an interview? That depends, Sabarna Paul, because interviewer, he might expect some things. And based on that, you have to, give your things. Do you need to, okay, we can add our photo in the resume. I would say No, or I would not, advise you to upload any photos. So, anything else, guys? Please do subscribe our YouTube channel if you have not done. Please also ring the bell button. You can actually rate your key skills. You can actually rate your key skills. So in terms of some let's say out of some 10 or something like that. Like if you have any technical key skills or any programming language like C, you can rate yourself as 7 out of 10, something like that. So these are see these infographics and demographics. You can have a as I told you, no declaration. No one will declare that all the consent, whatever you have given, is true. All these things is not required. Resume should not include more than a page. It is recommended. I am not saying it should not. Yes, you can have a two-page resume also, but it is recommended that you have a a single page resume. That is enough. Okay, guys. It was really nice having you all here. So we are happy to, create more such useful session to you. So make sure that you do attend all these sessions. Okay, if you have any doubts, come back and watch the recording. Okay, in the YouTube. And make sure that you have an amazing career ahead of you. I wish you all the best. Okay, we'll be in touch. I'll be meeting you guys again. Okay, so make sure you do come back. So push the bell icon so that whenever we come with live sessions, okay, we'll definitely give you the notification. So it was great. I have some.